Hi, how you doing? Welcome to another session with Grandpa on watercolors, Van Gogh style. Sky, mountains, forest here, and then the meadow here. Already touched up with some crimson color on moose here that will be the main feature in a picture. So let's start here with some sky. And since we're trying to have fun, I'll do sky kind of with clouds built into it. And there's another cloud there. And we'll be a little bit more Van Gogh-ish with kind of the sky. Going around the clouds and showing them off. Okay, done with this. With that, now we're going to go with the mountains here. So basically, let's just draw some lines down here from the peaks. And these lines are going to be sort of Grandpa Butler cheats here. So what, and now we'll draw second lines, triangles from the main lines. So they're going to define our kind of valleys here on the mountains here. So we're going to spray them with a mist here, and we're learning out how to do that. And Grandpa is not really good at that yet. He's still trying to figure that out. I think we're going to try and leave some of these spaces as white, as if there's snow on them. And then I'm pressing a little harder here and there, as if there's cliff showing, sort of mountain structure here. And that'd be a good place to have lots of snow, huh? Maybe just hints of mountain there. And coming down here. Between the trees there. Have that mountain color going in there, and this helps set off the trees. Same there. So Grandpa's been doing this since May 2021 with the crayons, and just the last couple weeks decided he ought to not to start misting instead of stroking, speed things up, leave more of the sort of Van Gogh-like structure in the with the pigment in the paint, so don't dissipate it too much. And yet, keep the brush handy. So as to move paint around when it's after it gets missed, when you feel like you want to be spontaneous that way, in that moment there. Which we may want to be, who knows. This is an ongoing experiment, and there's an ongoing experiment with the mountains. Now, with the trees, we have this crimson. Let's put in a few crimson bits here and there at the bottom, so it's like it's woody. And why not? It's a nice color here and there showing through the trees, maybe trunks of trees. We'll give it that impression here. Okay. And now we'll go through with with our crayons here, watercolor crayons. Again, we'll mist them back together and trust that the misting and the good luck will help get us here. And so what Grandpa's doing right here is he's pushing hard, getting some dark stuff here on the bottom, as if that's the shadiest part. And he's going to leave space for the sun to shine on some of the branches, or more sunlight or more exposure. You can interpret it however you want to. That's how what's going through his mind as he's doing this. And you're saying, well, Grandpa, we love you, so we forgive you for your artistic ignorance here. Thank you, my lovely grandchildren. You are amazing people. I appreciate that. Appreciate my girlfriend, 50 years, for encouraging me to get back into this after a long time away. And getting me the watercolor crayons. They've been fun. Just started doing them in 2021. And pen and ink started. Grandson Soren has helped make this possible by his expert advice and help. Appreciate that. Appreciate the encouragement of my daughter-in-law's daughter for putting the videos on. And I appreciate whoever you are for taking the maybe wrong advice and watching this. But hey, welcome aboard. So when we do this, this is all experiment. I mean, every video is like a new experiment. And this experiment here is an experiment in color and having fun. Because if you're not having fun, you won't do this, right? Well, if you make money, that would be a reason. But Grandpa's beyond his artistic level is not high enough to reach the make money category. And so he's staying in the have fun category of painters. I'm sure that Aristotle used watercolor crayons when he was developing his philosophy and his ethics. Only when he wanted to get away from the sophists. And I said, hey, my dear wife, where are my crayons? Give me my crayons. So I'm going through here now and just kind of spotting this up with the third color here, where there are white spaces. It's okay to have white spaces. But we're going to mist it, so we are not planning on using a lot of stroking with our brush. We're planning on mostly mystifying this area. And so let's see what happens when we get it. So we're now almost ready after mixing this up. And when you draw things like this, don't be too symmetrical, evenly spaced. Trees all evenly height, the same height. Grandpa would advise anyway that you kind of mix it up from time to time. And maybe even here with your crayon, maybe a dark green in the background here and there. Just so it looks different. Okay, there's our trees. Now we come down to our meadows here. I'm not sure exactly what's the best way to proceed. I can do this yellow here. except around the moose's head here, we're going to have some ochre, kind of a yellow color. I'm turning it sideways to get some of the pigment kind of laid out here as if it's kind of, we're looking at drying out grass, dried out grass here. And then maybe we'll have bits of red here and there as if there is some grass. And we put some red where we have the moose here is kind of, see, we had the lines under, black lines to kind of represent grass there. Okay. I'm not sure what we want to do about the foreground, actually. I think we may have missed it and then swipe it a couple times with our little watercolor brush. Okay, but it's time to mist it up. And before I do that, let me just do a little bit of cloud infrastructure here. Okay. And ta-da! Grandpa hasn't figured out the formula, so let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. I don't know if that's nearly enough. Did it come alive at all? I was doing that. I was paying too much attention to not messing up. Now we have our little brush here. And anything we should work here from lighter to darker. Well, that seems to go quickly. I kind of like what that did. So that may be our new normal here, huh? And maybe dab on the trees here where it looks like green is underrepresented. Now what to do about the mountains? I actually should have started up there and come down. Don't ever do this like Grandpa does. Do it better. Okay. We should work, start at the top and work down, except I was trying to go from light to dark. Okay, and between dab here, dab there, dab a little bit. I want to leave the pigment, mostly, where it is, because that's kind of cool. Okay, and now we've got the mountains. Now the deal about the mountains is, let's do the clouds first. How's that? The clouds here. Hmm. rain mist on it. So we did it 10 times, 10 squirts, six, kind of around in a specific pattern over our picture and four kind of general. And now we have the mountains. Should have had a cup of water ready. That's how it goes. You old people. Okay, so I think what we're doing here, we're finding that colors will come out even better, Grandpa, if you use a brush after you mist. Okay, so you can see kind of what we mean by the snow, leaving pigment behind here and there. There's a bunch of snow up there. Mountainside, snow, 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 snow. Trees here. Okay. I think that was pretty fun. Okay, that's probably steep. Right here, and probably not so much snow right there. Okay, does that feel like that was impressionistic and quick enough? Yeah, I think so. So we'll let it dry out here. Hey, thanks for watching. Appreciate your being with us. Bye-bye.